The purpose of life. Is it to multiply? Is it to play catch? Or is it to argue over who is the better waifu? Historia or Armin dressed as Historia? These questions disturbed me. But in today's video, we will be going over AOT chapter 137 through 138 and discussing all that's within these chapters. Let's get into it. First off, we start with Zeke and Armin playing sandcastles talking about humanity, because who doesn't do that? Zeke believes there is no purpose beyond multiplying and continuing this life of hate and fear. This makes Zeke's euthanasia plan make sense, and I can't blame him for feeling this way. In a world where people war, fight, and oppress over the simplest of issues, no wonder Zeke would want to end the Eldian's ability to give birth. It solves so many issues that he's talking about. Armin, on the other hand, has a more humanist approach that I'm more in line with. He tells Zeke there is no purpose or meaning to life, and that it's what you really make of it, not what you get out of it. For Armin, that moment of him running behind Eren and Mikasa in the gentle warm breeze as leaf flutters around him, to him, that felt good, and so that made life worth it to him. Then the leaf and the ball panels showed that Zeke's moment was him playing catch, and he realized that he just wanted to go back and play catch peacefully again. And really, this is what life's about at the end of the day. It's what you want to do, what you want to achieve, all in the name of the pursuit of happiness. Humans all want only a handful of things to be happy, and we are all simultaneously trying to get to that point through the means which we think are the most correct. Back to reality, it seems something fishy is happening. The Titans that once turned on them are now helping them fend off Titans. Mikasa uses this moment to go after Ymir, and with a little teamwork from sharpshooter Gabby, is able to free Armin, though not without Armin's thigh being pierced by a quick tongue, which prompts Armin to use a thunder spear to annihilate the Titan and fall gently into Annie's hand. This may be the closest AOT will ever get to romance, so you all better enjoy this moment just as much as I will. And this leads to Zeke? Okay, well, Zeke shows up from a bone of Eren's and reminds us how Levi wanted to talk to Zeke. Well, Zeke, on the other hand, couldn't say the same, which prompts Levi to chop his fucking head off. Holy shit. But before that, we get a moment of clarity with both Armin and Zeke. Zeke forgiving his father, telling Ksaver, I forget how to pronounce his name, I'm sorry, that while the plan didn't work, and even though he still believes in it, that all he wants to do is play catch with him again. Armin apologizes to Berthold, but knows that there is no other option than to wake up from here and fight. So they both ask for their strength, and that's why those Titans that resembled our heroes and villains previously are now helping them. This was a pretty beautiful moment, if I say so myself, and Zeke's death, it was pretty damn good. At the end of the day, Zeke realized what made him happy, and that was family. Not this endless crusade towards euthanasia, no matter if he believes in it or not. And no matter the outcome, he knew that his days were numbered. And so, the rumbling stops. Eren's head is severed from his giant bone body, and as this organism tries to reattach Eren's head to its body, the shield of Marley stops it. And then Armin detonates and says goodbye to Eren. So as the rumbling has stopped, all around the world, the Titans, which had surely threatened all life, has been stopped in their tracks. Now with only a headache and a memory from Mikasa, the world can finally start to recover, but oh god, Eren's still alive. That's right. Out from the rubble, Armin and Reiner made it, but so did their buddy old pal, Eren. So their new goal is to stop the glowing organism while the rest deal with Eren as a colossal Titan. Yeah, that's pretty badass. But as this occurs, everyone has finally reunited again, and there is only one way these kinds of warm moments end in AOT, and that's with everyone turning into a Titan, killing all of our heroes in the process. Fun. Thanks, Obama. This doesn't stop Reiner, though, as he goes toe-to-toe with the Tentacle Monster. That's what I'm gonna call it. While this happens, Armin and Eren face off in a Hoss battle of the ages, a real test of metal. This is the true embodiment of my Discord bio. Two meaty men slapping meat. That's right, and literally everyone else jumps into the piles, too. From the Titanized forms of John, Connie, and Gabby, to even Annie, who's playing her own little game of tug of war. But as Mikasa, witnessing this, she realizes, well, she's getting a little bit too old for this shit. That's right. Early 20s Mikasa is getting too old for Eren's shit, and she's had it up to here and is going to do what she should have done from the very beginning. Ask Eren to hand in his gun and badge. This is absolutely a euphemism for cutting off Eren's dick. And so, what better way to do that than to enter a world where Eren is married to Mikasa? Marriage jokes. So yeah, this is a reality where Eren and Mikasa ran away together, something Mikasa had always wanted deep down to do, but knew it wasn't the right option. So that night, when Mikasa had the chance to tell Eren everything, she instead didn't, and made what is very hard to believe here, somehow the right option. As if she made this decision, everyone would have pretty much died, and Paradis would have fallen to Marley. And so Eren asks Mikasa to forget about him, to throw away her scarf and do what she must to put an end to this war. Except Mikasa can't do that. Well, the scarf thing. She does the rest of it, though. So they destroy Eren's pearly whites, and the dream dies. Mikasa severs the head of Eren Jaeger, putting an end to this war. What an ending. Mikasa was the one to end Eren's life. The man who told Mikasa he hated her, but also was the man she loved unconditionally. In the end, would die to her hands, saving everyone in the process. If you ask me how AOT would have ended nearly a decade ago, this is not the outcome I would have predicted. But either way, no matter what the next chapter holds, this was just an amazing chapter. I also know there are people out there who, for some reason, think these chapters of AOT are trash, fire, garbage, but I don't understand how one could come to that conclusion reading what I read. Everything was pretty well built up, and the execution, no pun intended there, was simply amazing. So tomorrow, I'm going to cover the last chapter of Attack on Titan, and I hope you will all be there to see it. Once again, thank you all for joining me on this journey. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe, like the video, and all of that jazz. Thank you for watching, everyone. I'll see you tomorrow.